Any discussion of aliens and UFOs would certainly include some reference to Billy Meyer and the Pleiadians, Randall Winters, George Green, Semyasi, Ptah, Ascot, and Quetzal. I think there are more, but I can't remember them at this moment. Oh, Wendell Stevens is another major player in that crowd. The most amazing tales were told and hundreds of predictions made, and many of them came true, including 9/11. And I'm going to read you some of the most interesting aspects of the Henoch prophecies after I read Quetzal's caveat about prophecy. He says, now look at the date, February 28th, 1987. This is 5,309 days before September 11th, 2001. 14 and a half years before 9/11, Quetzal told Billy Meyer that this would happen. It's documented. And there are more prophecies that haven't happened yet, and that's what I want to read to you. Quetzal tells Billy, before I give you a clear account of the prophecies of Henoch, I would like to point out that prophecies are always changeable and can be changed for the better if man makes positive changes in his thoughts, feelings, and actions, leading to that which is better and positively progressive. Prophecies always rest upon specific causes. These again result in certain effects, whereby these effects can be changed at any time if only the preceding causes are changed in their form. Therefore, it is possible that negative or evil prophecies do not have to be fulfilled if the preceding causes will be purposely changed in a manner that positivity and good develop instead of negativity and evil. However, this does not apply to predictions, as these rest upon events that cannot be changed, are inevitable, and surely and definitely will occur in the future. Predictions rest upon a preview, and thus on a direct viewing of the future, and have to do with neither prophecy nor with calculation of probability. So when I make a portion of Henoch prophecies for the third millennium known to you, it does not mean that they have to be fulfilled, because the prerequisite of fulfillment in each case would be that the already existing causes continue to exist, as also continue to be created in the future, so that a fulfillment of the prophecies can come to pass. Thus, provided that human beings of Earth will become reasonable, the possibility exists that by a reasonable change in the way of thinking, as well as a reasonable development in feeling, and an equally reasonable way of acting, everything changes for the better and positive, whereby prophecies do not have to be fulfilled. However, if this transformation does not occur, a very evil, wicked, and negative time lies ahead for the Earth and its entire population in the coming new millennium. Okay, that's the end of Quetzal's warning. Now, I can't read all of the dialogue on this page. You'll have to do that yourself, but I will read some of the predictions for America and Europe. Note the date, February 28th, 1987. It's Saturday night at 2 o'clock in the morning. What is Billy Meyer doing? He's talking to aliens. What are the aliens telling him? The future events of Earth. I'll start with destruction in North America. Does that sound interesting? Here's what Quetzal tells Billy Meyer. Far in the West, it will be different. The United States of America will be a country of total destruction. The cause for this will be manifold, with her global conflicts, which are continuously instigated by her, and which will continue far into the future. America is creating enormous hatred against her, worldwide, in many countries. As a result, America will experience enormous catastrophes, which will reach proportions barely imaginable to the people of Earth. The destruction of the World Trade Center by terrorists will only be the beginning. Yet all the apocalyptic events will not only be brought about due to the use of unbelievably deadly and destructive weapons such as chemical, laser, and others, and by cloned murder machines, but in addition to this, the Earth and nature, maltreated to the deepest depths by the irresponsible human beings of Earth, will rise up and cause destruction and bring death onto the Earth. Enormous firestorms and gigantic hurricanes will sweep over the USA and bring devastation, destruction, and annihilation, as this from time immemorial never before will have happened. Not only will America, but also all other Western industrial countries, which still live at the beginning of the new millennium in the delusion that they could dominate and rule over underdeveloped nations, that is, third world countries, will not only soon lose influence over these, but must defend themselves against them. According to the prophecies of Henoch, The truth about industrialized countries is that they only seem to appear to be true civilizations, but in fact, they are not. Because more and more at the end of the 20th century and the beginning of the third millennium, they will disregard all true love, true freedom, and true wisdom, as well as true peace, along with all values of humaneness and all values of men's and women's true being. But not even all the terrible happenings will hinder the USA in continuing to proceed with her actions against all countries. Even when the North American continent will be stricken by the most terrible catastrophe which has ever been recorded, even military powers will wreak havoc with computerized and nuclear, biological, and chemical weapons, whereby it will also happen that computerized weapons become independent and cannot be controlled any longer by human beings. Overall, this is the most important part of Enoch's prophecies. Okay, now I want to skip down to the part that says, wars and devastation in Europe and North America. Yet Russia will not rest and will attack Scandinavia, and in doing so will embroil all of Europe. And months before that, a terrible tornado will have swept across northern Europe, causing great devastation and destruction. It must still be stated that the Russian attack will occur during the summer. In fact, starting from Arhangelsk. Denmark will not be dragged into the war due to the insignificance of this country. Yet Russia will not be satisfied with this action of war, as her will for expansion will be ravenous. And consequently, Russia will launch a military attack against Iran and Turkey and will conquer these two countries in bloody fighting, causing enormous destruction. Russia will attack Iran? In the Russian expansionist mentality will also be included the drive to contain control of Middle Eastern oil deposits, as well as to gain control of the southeastern region of Europe. Therefore, she will also invade the Balkans and conquer these countries there in enormous battles, causing ruthless and devastating destruction with many deaths. This will be at the time that tremendous natural disasters will hit Italy and its people, causing severe hardship. But this will also be at a time when Vesuvius could become active again and could spread tremendous havoc. At the same time, a war will shake Italy and claim many human lives, as well as cause great destruction. Destruction of war will descend in the northern countries, as strong military forces will invade them from the east and will pillage and murder, as well as use bombs and missiles, like hail coming down and hitherto unknown weapons of laser and computer-controlled types, which will destroy and annihilate everything, whereby the first target will be Hungary, and after that will follow Austria and northern Italy. Switzerland will also be severely affected, but will not be the actual target. This will be France and Spain. However, the main object of the aggressors will be to bring all of Europe under their military control, and for that purpose, France will be selected to be the headquarters. France will not only be invaded by the aggressors from the outside, but will also be conquered from within as a result of collaborative forces and other forces. This can be envisioned as being the many foreigners of a different religion living in France at that time, and specifically Islam, which will be this force working from within. Once France has fallen, a war to conquer Spain and England will take place. Subsequently, an alliance with the forces of the aggressors will be formed, which will invade Scandinavia. For all these French-based military operations, the weapons of mass destruction stored in the arsenals of France will be used and cause evil devastation, destruction, and annihilation. The aggressors from the east will force the French army to join their military forces and lead a war of conquest against the northern countries of Europe, invading and conquering Sweden and Norway. Subsequently, these northern countries will be annexed by Russia. Military forces will also attack Finland, whereby many will be killed and enormous destruction will be caused. At the same time, as civil war rages in Germany, an enormous bloody revolution will break out in England, which will claim more lives than will be claimed by the civil war in Germany. And because England and Ireland have been at war for a long time already, due to the IRA and the police and the military forces of England, the result will be, because this feud will continue up to that time, that this revolution will spread out to all of Ireland, especially affecting Northern Ireland. Many lives will be lost during a civil war in Wales, where differences between various parties will arise before the Third World War. Welsh and English forces will clash, especially near Simru, and claim many lives and cause great destruction. But death, destruction, and annihilation will not only rage in Europe, but also in America, where much suffering will have to be endured, and many deaths, as well as destruction and annihilation, will be. America and Russia will have the most terrible weapons of mass destruction at their disposal, a fact which is already the case to a certain extent today, and will clash with violent force against each other at that time of conflict, whereby Canada will also be dragged into this conflict. The source of this conflict will substantiate the Russian attack on the American state of Alaska and against Canada. This conflict will result in mass killings of human beings, as well as devastating destruction, annihilation, and epidemics, etc., which mankind of Earth will never have seen and experienced up until that time. Not only nuclear, biological, and chemical weapons will be used in mass, but also enormously deadly systems of computer-controlled weapons that are only in the beginning stages of development today, or will be invented and constructed during the third millennium. Worldwide natural catastrophes. As already mentioned, enormous natural catastrophes and rolling walls of fire and violent hurricanes will rage all across America, while in addition, all the terrible effects of war will bring thousandfold deaths, destruction, and annihilation. America's largest cities will be absolutely destroyed, and firestorms will cause great disaster and misery. Severe earthquakes and volcanic eruptions will also belong to that time, and these will cause much suffering and misery and deaths, besides enormous destruction and devastation, as all of nature and the planet itself will rise up against the insanity of human beings on Earth. However, tornadoes, earthquakes, and volcanic eruptions will not only rage in America, but also in Europe and in the rest of the world. These activities have already begun at the present time, also during the past decades, with the exception that they will become increasingly more devastating in the future. And man of Earth is guilty for the most part today, as also in the future. It is man who will destroy the entire environment, all of nature, the atmosphere, water, and all the resources of the planet. And through this, a shifting of weight inside the Earth takes place, caused, for example, by the creation of gigantic lakes by damming and creating hollow caverns due to the exploitation of petroleum and gas, etc., and thereby unnatural inner Earth movements are created, which also lead to unnatural tectonic effects and cause earthquakes and volcanic eruptions, which also in turn cause enormous climatic changes, resulting in horrendous tornadoes of devastating proportions, which in the end will set their destructive energies free on the entire world. All of this will lead to increasingly horrible floods and unusually massive snowfalls, which will advance to the southern countries and finally even to the equatorial regions. Because through the insanity of human beings, the Earth has begun unnoticeably to spin strangely as a consequence of atomic explosions inside and on the surface of the Earth. And this will be the reason that the planet will slowly but surely enter an extraordinary spinning orbit around the Sun, while the first phase is already occurring, which causes a change in climate, leading to a new ice age, civil wars, and anarchy in America. Yet the misery on Earth will continue as two terrible civil wars will break out in America, whereby one will follow the other. Afterwards, the United States of America will break apart and deadly hostility will prevail among her, which then leads to the division into five different territories, and it cannot be prevented that sectarian fanatics will play a dictatorial role. Anarchy will be the worldwide condition that will prevail and torment human beings over a long period of time, as human beings will also be tormented by the many epidemics and diseases, many of them new and unknown to human beings, and for this reason, incurable. Due to this fact, the bodies of many human beings will slowly and miserably decay, while unbearable pain will also occur, as well as blindness and terrible respiratory problems that lead to suffocation. The consciousness of many human beings will become impaired and succumb to feeble-mindedness and insanity, and all these gruesome occurrences will be traceable to biological and chemical weapons, which are the cause of not fast, but gruesome and slow deaths. And this will also occur due to the use of ray and frequency weapons, which are already being developed today. 1987. Finally, the words of Enoch may be specifically mentioned which include that mankind of Earth, in pursuit of technology for mass destruction and greed for power, hatred, vengeance, and riches, will ignore all values of creation and will trample upon all values of love, wisdom, freedom, and peace, as ancestors of the Enoch lineage have done before, to plunge the world into screaming misery, death, destruction, and annihilation, and into the most severe catastrophes mankind of Earth will ever have experienced. Thanks for watching. Events that cannot be changed are inevitable and surely and definitely will occur in the future. Predictions rest upon a preview and thus on a direct viewing of the future and have to do with neither prophecy nor with calculation of probability. So when I make a portion of Enoch prophecies for the third millennium known to you, it does not mean that they have to be fulfilled, because the prerequisite of fulfillment in each case would be that the already existing causes continue to exist as also continue to be created in the future, so that a fulfillment of the prophecies can come to pass in his thoughts, feelings, and actions, leading to that which is better and positively progressive. Prophecies always rest upon specific causes. These again result in certain effects, whereby these effects can be changed at any time if only the preceding causes are changed in their form. Therefore, it is possible that negative or evil prophecies do not have to be fulfilled if the preceding causes will be purposely changed in a manner that positivity and good develop instead of negativity and evil. However, this does not apply to predictions, as these rest upon it. Thus, provided that human beings of Earth will become reasonable, the possibility exists that by a reasonable change in the way of thinking, as well as a reasonable development in feeling, and an equally reasonable way of acting, everything changes for the better and positive, whereby prophecies do not have to be fulfilled. However, if this transformation does not occur, a very evil, wicked, and negative time lies ahead for the Earth and its entire population in the coming new millennium. Okay, that's the end of Quetzal's warning. Now, I can't read all of the dialogue on this page. You'll have to do that yourself. Any discussion of aliens and UFOs would certainly include some reference to Billy Meyer and the Pleiadians, Randall Winters, George Green, Semyasi, Ptah, Ascot, and Quetzal. I think there are more, but I can't remember them at this moment. Oh, Wendell Stevens is another major player in that crowd. The most amazing tales were told and hundreds of predictions made, and many of them came true, including 9/11. And I'm going to read you some of the most interesting aspects of the Enoch prophecies after I read Quetzal's caveat about prophecy. He says, now look at the date. February 28th, 1987, this is 5,309 days before September 11th, 2001. 14 and a half years before 9/11, Quetzal told Billy Meyer that this would happen. It's documented, and there are more prophecies that haven't happened yet, and that's what I want to read to you. Quetzal tells Billy, before I give you a clear account of the prophecies of Enoch, I would like to point out that prophecies are always changeable and can be changed for the better if man makes positive changes.